This episode of TechZilla is brought to you by ShareFile by Citrix. 5 free ways to speed up your Windows or Mac PC. I think Patrick's forgetting how to count again.
I may be forgetting how to. It could be 7. It could be 5. Let's speed up your machine
10.
In any case. Turn off stuff you aren't using. Seriously.
Yeah.
Especially if you just bought a new machine, start by uninstalling applications you don't use. Just make them go away. Don't use it. Uninstall it. Then turn off stuff you don't need that starts by default. In OS X, go to System Preferences, go to Users and Groups, go to Login Items, and stuff you don't need every time you start your machine, just make it go away. Like,
ooh.
Okay, now I'll restart with Dropbox and BitTorrent Sync, and if you thought to yourself, Dropbox just takes too much, delete that too. Of course, now I'm going to have to turn it back on, but that's a whole other conversation. If you're in Windows, you right-click on the Start button or hit Control-Alt-Delete, open up the Task Manager, and then go to the Start tab, and that gives you information on everything that starts when Windows starts.
Aha,
so, do you need Dropbox to start? Okay, what about that weird combo of letters like Event Manager application? Okay, that's part of your Epson printer monitor, HKCMD mobile. Oh my goodness, that sounds actually, just Google it. It's not nearly as scary as you think. Logitech Download Assistant, that seems like something.
I don't think I need that.
No.
I think that's for a webcam. I'll disable that right now.
Bye.
Cool.
Realtek HD Audio
Windows
Manager.
Task Manager.
You like sound. Easy. Yeah. But basically, right-click, select properties. If you don't know what something is, like, let's see the Realtek HD Audio Manager. Obviously,
Realtek
this is
HD
your sound
Audio
thing,
Manager.
But if you right-click on it, Windows will give you some basic info of what's going on
yes.
there.
Yes.
And like I
properties.
Said before, if it sounds really weird, well, there's not a lot of information there.
It's enough to understand, though.
Yeah. And if it isn't, Google that information, that weird name online. Then start snooping. Resmon or Task Manager on Windows. Actually, if you click over to the Processes tab over there,
mm-hmm.
it's always amazing to see like what's taking. If your machine
yes.
feels really slow, chances are, look, you'll open it up and you can sort by the column. So let's sort for CPU and see what's taking up all the CPU cycles on your machine. Look, it's Google Chrome, the Task Manager, as you switch to
figure.
The Task Manager. Well, if you had 100 tabs open, it would be
yes.
like 90% for Google Chrome.
Mm-hmm.
Resmon's another really cool tool on Windows. The Activity Monitor utility in Windows, the Activity Monitor utility in OS X, which I just opened up here, does the same basic thing. If your machine's slowing down, specifically with one app, this is a good way to configure. Like, oh, look, Shockwave Flash. Invariably sucking down a lot of CPU, although 10% may be the lowest amount I've ever seen Flash running. But it gives you an idea of what's running on your machine, and you can look to see what it's doing, and you can click through to get the memory. Memory is harder to kind of figure out what's going on there, but CPU, if you're like at 50 or 100% CPU, that gives you a good idea that you either need to close a whole bunch of tabs or maybe think about using a different application.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
By the way, Windows users, make sure you're running antivirus or malware. At the very least, the free Microsoft Security Essentials for Windows 7 and earlier, or Windows Defender in 8 and 8.1. And it has to be updated. No matter what service you use, you must keep your antivirus or anti-malware updated. And by the way, while you're thinking about it, go ahead and do a full scan. It's not a bad idea to run anti-malware in OS X, but OS X is a lot less likely to have some weird piece of cruft sucking down clock cycles from your CPU. Cleaning weird malware out of a PC can take it from unusable to spiffy. It's kind of frightening, actually, how even if it's just a bunch crud in the background.
I remember being a little kid and my dad got so mad at me because I was downloading stuff off of like Napster. Apparently, I downloaded some malware, didn't know it at the time, but
you
he was
rooted
like, you
your
need to make
machine.
Sure you keep, what was he using, Norton
yeah.
antivirus? I use AVG myself, which is perfect. It's free and it's easy right. to use, so.
I've been using Microsoft Essentials for so long, I went straight to Defender. Oh, updates, while we're talking about updates. Just automate them.
Yeah.
OS X does a pretty good job of updating your hardware drivers, but Windows folks, make sure you have the latest drivers for your hardware on Windows, especially graphics drivers. Go to your desktop or laptop manufacturer's website or straight to NVIDIA or AMD or Intel for your desktop to get the latest drivers. If you're on a Windows PC, defrag your hard drive. I know I'm going to get emails because some of you are going to be like, no, actually, defragging does not make a noticeable increase in performance. Great. Do it anyway, just in case. And if you're on OS X, get the 2 or 3 gigabytes of photos and stuff off of your desktop, put it on the hard drive, put an alias to the file folder with that information on your hard drive. You will be shocked. A couple of, like, even a gigabyte on your desktop in OS X will make the machine start to tank in performance. And while we're talking about performance, dump piggy apps. Dump Internet Explorer or Safari for Firefox, Opera, or Chrome. Okay, Internet Explorer has gotten better. Safari still sucks. My number one favorite, replacing Adobe Reader with Foxit.
Yes.
And of course, you don't need either one of those in OS X because it's all handled inside of Premiere. You want to get really hardcore? Reinstall your operating system every 6 months or a year. Bit rot happens. Just APIs and stuff in the background I don't want to really get into just starts to degrade, gets patched, gets crufted, gets lost, gets overwritten, and slowly over time your machine is just, it's like scraping barnacles off the side of a boat.
On my gaming PC at home is so slow, and I'm just like, I'll do it after the wedding. After the wedding, God.
That's a good plan.
Oh.
But after the wedding, she'll reinstall the operating system and the machine will speed up. You know, seriously, reinstalling your OS, or better yet, reinstalling a clean image. Like, once you have the perfect configuration, create an image of that. We've talked about how to do that on Techzilla a whole bunch. And then you can reinstall a clean image in like 20 minutes instead of spending hours and days updating your system and reinstalling the operating system from scratch. Now, if you want to spend money, get a solid state drive if you don't have one. It's amazing. That is the number one. If you don't have an SSD in your machine, that is the number one speed upgrade I can offer you for money. Bump your Windows or Mac machine up to 8 gigabytes if you're at 4 gigabytes or less. Windows 8 runs very well in older laptops or netbooks that cap out at 2 gigabytes of RAM because of the way it handles system memory. Oh. It does a much nicer, it's just a very elegant way of handling system memory. So if you have a little tiny bit of RAM, Windows 8 might be worth upgrading to. And if gaming is your thing, consider a GPU upgrade. And if your machine is more than 3 to 5 years old, you might be amazed at how fast a new computer is, though I try to keep my hardware for 5 years if I can. But what was smoking fast 5 years ago seems slow now.
God, it's so true.